big part of it is talking about gentle touch. And so this kind of goes into that more. And so touch is the most powerful of all interactions between parent and child. And research during the 1940s indicated that children placed in hospitals and that were deprived of physical contact with their mothers actually developed profound depression and lack of appetite. So this is kind of like if you guys have heard of failure to thrive, it's that where children, they can actually die if they're not stimulated by a caregiver. So they just stop gaining weight. Even if you try to feed them, they won't take in the calories. It's like their body just won't absorb the milk at that time. And you'll see that too, I've talked about it before, but like in orphanages, more in like the area of like, I think it was more Russia, where the babies are just placed basically in their cribs and they weren't touched or held. And they're really, really delayed, and some of them died from not being held enough. And touch is a mirror of our inner feelings toward another person. And so children can actually sense what a parent is feeling by the way they are touched. Have you guys ever actually thought about that?
Sometimes, yes. I mean, it's different for me because I grew up on the other end. So, like, I know what it feels like, you know? So it's very important for me to break that cycle and to make sure that he doesn't ever feel those things. So he knows, you know, like kids, they know. They know when we're upset, you know, when, you know.
And when we're angry or sad, we tend to not touch them.
Right.
That's
or like just, yeah.
Yeah, so it goes towards the neglect side.
Right.
That's a big thing to be aware of. Okay, so there's this concept called your touch history. So everyone has a personal touch history, and it's comprised of all the touch experiences that we have had during our lifetime. And it doesn't matter how old a person is, everyone has a touch history, including baby. History is comprised of three kinds of touch: hurting, scary, and nurturing. So a hurting touch are things like being spanked, scrapes, cuts, operations, being raped or attacked, or even broken bones. A scary touch can be things like unwanted sexual touches, so like being molested, or even threats of a hurting touch. So parent or even another child tells them, like, I'm going to break your neck. So anytime there's fear involved. And then a nurturing touch are when it's a positive thing. So if a parent rubs them, like a back rub, pats, massages, or hugs. So when it's a good intention. And so nurturing touch, the experience is one of the nicest gifts a parent can give their child. It has immediate positive and comforting effects. Babies who receive regular nurturing touch show increased weight gain, improved body tone. They're very alert and they can be consoled. Decreases stress by decreasing the levels of the hormone cortisol, which is elevated during periods of stress. So have you guys seen those commercials for like weight loss commercials because of cortisol? Where they say that the medication will decrease cortisol so you'll lose weight. So that happens when you're stressed, your body produces cortisol. And your body kind of goes haywire and you'll end up eating a lot more. Because when we're stressed, food is things like dopamine. And it helps you feel comforted. So when we touch somebody in a nurturing way, it helps to decrease the cortisol. So we feel calm. And a good way of helping a child calm down is to massage them. And So it's a systematic way of doing nurturing touches through like infant massage, but you can do it with any child of any age. And it increases dopamine and serotonin levels. And so those are the neurotransmitters that are affected with depression. So that can help increase your mood levels and decrease depression. So anytime you're touching your child in a nurturing way, you're helping them with their mood. And you can help prevent depression, especially if it is something that's in your family history. It's really important to help try to prevent that. So now it's your turn to think about your life. So think back from your childhood to now, and what percentage of touch for you was a hurting touch, a scary touch, or a nurturing touch? So think about that to yourself. And then I want you guys to think about examples of each type of touch that you experienced. And then if anybody wants to share.
What question is it? The percentage?
Yeah, either one or both.
What if you didn't really get any of them? I'm just kidding.
That could be an option too.
I got all three of them. I was gonna try to go to the email so I can see the paper.
Yeah, that's where it came from.
Because I can't see the questions. I can only see my touch history.
That's what we're at. Right underneath it. Right underneath where it says my touch history, it says what percentages of touch have you received in your lifetime? In each of the categories, so it says hurting, scary, nurturing, or what have you given? Which have you given?
Yeah, it was different. Yeah, my bad. It was different from the paper.
Yeah, it's underneath.
when I was looking at the paper, I identified each one.
Yeah, it's more
detailed. Yeah, it's more detailed. That's why I wanted to look at the other paper. Okay, so for example. Well, the hurting one, of course, on a percentage, I would have to say it wasn't so often, only when I would get in trouble. The spanking, or for example, the scrapes when I fell off my bicycle, my dad's bicycle. That was funny. I thought I was going to get my ass beat.
What made you smart?
The what? Food?
Phone, I think.
Oh.
Ariel!
Yeah, I was reading all of them last point, and I had all the examples because I read this with my daughter.
Oh,
And then I was sharing with her all of the, like, each one. Let's see, what was the first one? The first one was spanking. I'll get back on it there, and it's great. That was a funny story when I fell off my dad's bicycle.
Did you hurt the bike too?
Yes, I did. I was young and dumb. There was this, I'll be honest. There was this lady that lived on our block. She was what we call nowadays a MILF. She was a hot looking lady. So she, you know, she had her sport car that drove manual transmission and all that, and she was getting her groceries and I looked over, I was riding my dad's bicycle and
You were checking her out.
Yeah, I was checking her out. She was wearing a skirt, so I see my friend from a distance, and I wanted to call and tell him, hey, the MILF is outside. So then I start riding fast, and by accident, I missed the pedal. I fell to the side, and my dad's bicycle rim hit the corner of a brick wall. I got up, and I said, oh, shit, I'm in trouble.
Yeah, for sure.
I start walking and limping, and my friend from a distance, he sees me, he's laughing. So then I get home, and I'm like, I'm going to get my ass. And then, sure enough, when I get home, I'm like, all right, I got to do something. I got to make myself cry. So I did that. My dad sees me, he told me what happened. And then I told him the truth. He started laughing. So... Well, that percentage that besides spanking, I would probably say 50%. 10%. The other one, what was it, scary?
Yeah.
That one, that isn't, happened to me. It's not unwanted sex, but it was. That's another crazy story. That's the first thing that happened to my head. It was a transsexual. A transsexual was leaving with her boyfriend from the store where I was working at, and she looked at me and checked me out because I wanted to close up the store, and she just went from my friend downstairs and she grabbed it. And I was like, "What the hell?" Yeah. So that was unwanted. That.
What did you do?
Huh?
What did you do?
I was like, what the hell? In front of her boyfriend. And she said, like, whoa. And I'm like, whoa, hey. Cut that out. I didn't know she was a tranny until she spoke. She looked like an elderly woman. And she started talking. I was like, whoa. Even after she did, I was like shocked. I'm like, what the hell? I just got violated. That was.
It's only funny because I'm feeling for them. It's not funny story. Like, I feel bad for you. I get it. But it's
like, it was funny.
Well, it's funny because you said, well, my friend downstairs. And I'm literally picturing you at the grocery store thinking, like, she went to your friend that was, like, downstairs. Oh, like, she went to your friend. But then you were like, my friend. I was like, oh, I get it.
Well, look. I was working at the time. Place that I was working at, it was a sex shop.
Oh.
So I was trying to close up and go home and get out, and then, you know, they were done, and then she's looking at me, and I'm like, what the hell? And then just like, wham, whimper. I was like, well, what the hell? And I was like, like, you guys gotta go. And she did it in front of her man.
Oh, he probably didn't care.
I don't know. That was unwanted.
Yeah.
And besides that, oh, the other one, the hug. The first thing that popped into my head when I thought about that one was my mom. All the time she would sit next to me, put her hand on mine, always, always, like, out of, like, randomly, like, out of nowhere. She'll call me and she'll, like, come give me a hug. So that's the first thing that popped into my head, my mom's hug. And she would do that often.
Yeah, me too.